Hi there, we've added new features to the Audioscan software for our 2023.2 software release. Today we're going to cover what's new for the Verifit 2, Axiom, and the Audioscan Noah module. Software for the Verifit 2 is now version 2023.2, Axiom is 2023.2, and the Audioscan Noah module is version 2.28. Please note that as of this software release, the Verifit 2 and Axiom software is named according to the year and the release number, instead of less obvious nomenclature. As always, the no-charge software update is available for download at audioscan.com. Software updates can also be done directly from the Audioscan Noah module by selecting Settings and clicking Check Now for Updates. Also note that a checkmark beside Check for Updates on Startup means that you will be notified when new software versions for your Audioscan equipment and Audioscan module are available. If an update is found, select Download and then Install. So, what's new in 2023.2? New features include an over-the-counter direct-to-consumer test suite for the Verifit 2, easier IP address selection in the Audioscan Noah module, and Japanese screen text on the Verifit 2 and Axiom. Over-the-counter direct-to-consumer test suite. The OTC-DTC test suite is purpose-built for testing over-the-counter and direct-to-consumer devices in your clinic. This provides a specific test protocol for adult customers with over-the-counter hearing aids and direct-to-consumer devices, enabling you to inform clients on device quality and device suitability. Another benefit is having an effective evaluation method of OTC-DTC devices, so you can make an informed decision as to which devices to sell in your clinic. It also provides an opportunity to grow your business by offering expanded services, making you the go-to clinic for all hearing services, among other possible uses as well. The test suite consists of two tests, ANSI CTA 2051 evaluation and audibility evaluation. We'll begin with the ANSI CTA 2051 evaluation. Measurements in the ANSI CTA 2051 evaluation are primarily derived from the ANSI CTA 2051 2017 standard. In October 22, the FDA made a ruling establishing over-the-counter hearing aids, specifying testing criteria that devices must meet to be sold as OTC hearing aids. The ruling also draws on ANSI S3.22 for hearing aids. However, the ANSI CTA standard is a main source for the tests and criteria. Testing is performed in the binaural test box using 0.4cc couplers. This enables efficient and accurate binaural testing of OTC and DTC devices. Measurements are automatically converted to 2cc equivalent values as required by the test standard. Before running a test, if possible, set the OTC hearing aids to test mode or program the devices with full-on gain settings with the widest possible frequency range and non-linear adapter processing minimized to the extent possible. Running the tests in user settings may result in measurement discrepancies and failure to meet OTC performance specifications. To get started, select the OTC DTC test suite from the Verifit 2 menu. With the ANSI CTA 2051 evaluation tab selected, configure each device for the left and right side to apply the core fig corrections used to calculate the insertion gain AD curve for evaluating bandwidth and smoothness. Configure stimulus as speech or swept peer tones. Where nonlinear adapter processing is active, tonal signals may result in invalid results. In these cases, speech, as specified in the ANSI CTA, should be used to avoid any measurement artifacts. Once the test is configured as desired, select play to start measurement. Once complete, measured tests that meet the FDA OTC final rule criteria will display a green checkmark, and measured tests that do not meet the FDA final rule criteria will display a yellow triangle warning symbol. The first test is maximum acoustic output sound pressure level with a 90 dB input. This ensures devices are not exceeding safe amplification limits for mild to moderate hearing loss, as defined by the FDA. An OTC hearing aid that has input controlled compression activated shall not exceed 117 dB SPL at any frequencies. Devices without input controlled compression shall not exceed 111 dB SPL. The result is transformed from 0.4cc and reported as a 2cc equivalent value. Bandwidth measures the frequency response across important speech frequencies to ensure the hearing aid amplifies across an acceptable frequency range. The measurement can be performed with a swept tone or a speech signal. Smoothness measures consistency of frequency response across the frequency spectrum to ensure suitable device performance. No single peak in the 1/3 octave frequency response shall exceed 12 dB relative to the average levels of the 1/3 octave bands, 2/3 octaves above and below the peak. THD plus N at 500 Hz is a measurement of unwanted hearing aid distortion and noise. Total harmonic distortion and noise is measured in the hearing aid at 100 dB SPL output level, across the measurement bandwidth. The result must not exceed 5%. Latency measures delay due to hearing aid processing, which can result in an undesirable misalignment between hearing aid process sound and direct sound. Devices must not exceed 15 milliseconds of latency. Internal noise measures the device-generated noise that may mask sounds that are desirable to the listener. Testing should be completed with processing that lowers the noise floor of the hearing aid turned off, such as auto-muting or downward expansion. Results should not exceed 32 dBA. High-frequency average full-on gain uses a 50 dB SPL pure tone to measure the output of a hearing aid with its gain set to maximum values, or full-on gain. The result is transformed from 0.4 cc and reported as a 2 cc equivalent value. There is no criteria for this test result. The second part of the OTC-DTC test suite is audibility evaluation, which offers tools for evaluating hearing devices according to NAL-NL2 and DSL-5 adult targets for mild to moderate sloping or flat sensory neural hearing loss using average adult transforms. First, set the left and right device type to apply the appropriate microphone location effect to the input test signal and coupling transform. Next, set venting by choosing the earpiece that best describes the client's earpiece. Selecting venting improves the accuracy of test box measurements by simulating on-ear venting effects. Audibility evaluation can be configured for soft, average, or loud speech, NAL-NL2 or DSL adult targets, and a flat or sloping hearing loss configuration. Each ear can be set as desired. Changing these parameters will result in an immediate shift of the gray target region shown on the screen. Once configured, select play and record tests. Once the test completes, the blue long-term average speech spectrum curve will display relative to the target area. If the blue line is within the gray target area, the device may be suitable for a mild to moderate hearing loss. If the blue line is above the gray target area, the device output is beyond the prescriptive targets, indicating the device may be too loud at the current user settings for a mild to moderate hearing loss, using the selected speech input level. If the blue line is below the gray target area, the device output may be too soft at the current user settings with the selected speech input level to achieve sufficient audibility for a mild hearing loss. The next feature is for easier selection of an AudioScan IP address when multiple AudioScan devices are connected to a PC. The AudioScan Noah module will now remember previously connected IP addresses, which can then be selected from the IP address drop-down menu. This makes it quick to switch between AudioScan equipment for transferring data, controlling an AudioScan from your PC, or updating the software of multiple AudioScan devices from one PC. We've continued to expand our multi-language support through the addition of Japanese screen text to the Verifit 2 and Axiom. Selecting Setup and then Devices allows the selection of screen language, English, German, Spanish, French, Portuguese, Simplified Chinese, and now Japanese, are available on the Verifit 2 and Axiom. This provides clinicians the comfort of using the AudioScan in their native language. Selecting a new language will require restarting. Upon rebooting, all relevant screen text is translated. Thank you for taking the time today to look at these new features. Full instructions are available in the updated user guide included with your download. Please visit our website for software downloads and for further information. And if you have questions, please feel free to contact us.